Good morning. My name is Pastor Scott Kirkhoff. I'm the pastor here at Faith Lutheran Church in Kent, Ohio. For those that are looking for a place to worship on Sunday morning, we are open. We have a 9 a.m. worship service followed by a fellowship time and a discipleship time. With that, grace, peace, and mercy to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Before I get into the sermon, I have to tell you that I have really struggled to record this sermon. I have been tongue-tied through about five different opportunities to present this message. So if I struggle with pronunciations, please forgive me because I need to get this video done. This last week, I had a great conversation with a young person concerning college. They were in their career, they were doing quite well, and they asked me the question, do you think I need to go to college? I responded with two answers. Number one, as I said, I think college still offers up the opportunity to open doors for you in the workforce, maybe not in the present, but certainly in the future. College offers huge opportunities for those who finish. Second, though, is it really reveals you to yourself. Going through a stressful situation, going through a challenge, and meeting that challenge is something that really reveals the person to themselves. You get to know the person that looks back to you in the mirror every day when you discover how you respond to stressful situations. So yes, I think college has a payout financially in the career workforce, but also probably more importantly, who you are as a person. We are people in Christ. We are called to be a resurrected people in Christ. But for us to really know who and what we are in Christ, that usually comes through challenges. Jesus, in our gospel lesson for this day, Matthew chapter 25, is talking to his disciples. And he's telling them, it's not only the destination that matters, but it's also the journey that matters. Don't forget about the journey. And as Christians, please don't forget about the ministry of being on the journey. Now, some people feel, well, why does nobody care about me? Why does nobody minister to me? Let me offer up this question. How are you ministering to other people? Are you part of the solution or are you part of the problem? Life is an exchange. It's a trade. In the workforce, we're just giving our time, talents, and our treasures in exchange for other people's time, talents, and treasures. In ministry, we are trying to first bless other people with our lives with the hope that they will, in exchange, bless us with their life. But the burden really falls upon us first. Jesus will be saying that. And as his resurrected people, as his resurrected hands and feet, Jesus says that we should be doing the ministry that we are called to do. And he will basically outline things that need to be done. He says in Matthew chapter 25, and it says, then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me. Basically, he says, those who were in need, the people of Christ tried to meet their needs. We have seen an incredibly divisive year in 2020. This election cycle was incredibly divisive right down the middle. We are living in a divided nation currently. Also, it's incredibly challenging because of COVID-19, the challenges of wearing a mask, the challenges of working from home. Blessed are you, those who have young children, trying to work with your children during this crisis, trying to get them educated. And along the way of this year, we have heard and seen many people who just thought, well, it doesn't matter. I'll just do whatever I want to do, and I'm not going to be worried about the person who is next to me. As Christians, as I've said, we're supposed to be part of the solution, not part of the problem. We're supposed to be good citizens. So we are to be ministering to others. Just because you don't want to wear a mask doesn't mean that you shouldn't wear a mask. Because if our neighbor is concerned about that, then we should also be concerned about that. We are trying to be like Christ. We are trying to be a blessing to others, both on the outside of the church and also on the inside of the church. But people have a tendency to become radically selfish in their sinful nature. So we have to check that. We have to go back to the basics. We have to ask the question, why would I want to minister to somebody else? Why would I want to bless somebody else? Why would I want to go through the challenges of trying to help somebody else? Well, let's look at what Christ has done for you. Jesus ministered to his own generation. He was actually executed, crucified by those who were intimidated by his ministry and his message. They put him on a cross because they were trying to take out their problem. But God the Father resurrected him from the dead. Jesus was crucified for you and for me, for our sins, so that we could be reconciled to the Father. And then he is resurrected on the third day. And in his resurrection, we have resurrection. In his hope, we have hope. In his peace, we have peace. In his love, we have love. And in his joy, we have joy. It's not the joy that we produce ourselves. It's the joy that he gives to us as being part of his body. See, stress is going to come to you whether you like it or not. Nobody wants to hear the words, you have cancer. Nobody wants to hear the words, somebody recently passed away in your life. Nobody wants to hear the words, we no longer have a job for you. Nobody wants to hear the words, schools are now closed again, and now you have to scramble to figure out how you're going to keep your kids busy and get them educated. Nobody wants to hear those things, but how you respond to them is up to you. So we have an opportunity as a resurrected people to stop, pause, park, think, and pray. We have the opportunity as Christians to call upon the wisdom of the Holy Spirit to give us insights how we can positively respond to the challenges of life and how we can minister to others who are going through similar challenges. Churches decline because they stop ministering. Churches increase because they rediscover ministry. Churches meet financial challenges when they understand that it's not their money, but it's the money that has been given to them by Christ. Churches move forward in the hope of Jesus Christ, not simply by the things of this world. So on Christ the King Sunday, this last Sunday of the church year, let us take an assessment of where we are at and how we are doing. Understand that Christ is going to return, but until his return, we are his body of Christ, or his body. We are his resurrected body. We are called to be doing his ministry his way, and as we do that, we show the world the love that he has given to us and the hope that we have in his resurrection. And with that, I will say amen and amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, may it guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.